You know, are you okay? We're just standing on top of this building. I don't know what we're doing up here. Surveying the city. We're not a hero. You know, we were supposed to be, going down to the local restaurant, maybe order a fudge pie, you know. Because, you know, I love chocolate. Chocolate's delicious. And maybe get some French fries as well. Potatoes. Oh, one of the best inventions ever. But seriously, why are we standing up here? Yeah, I get it. Surveying the city. What are we gonna do? I mean, what? Do you want me to, like, eat a burglar's head off? I mean, I can, but don't really want to. Well, okay, fine. We will bite the dude's head off, but why do you want to do that? You want to be like Venom? Oh, no. We are not being like my grandpa. Yeah, my grandpa, I'm the child of carnage. Anyway, look. We can't go around eating people. Doesn't really help with the hiding thing. You know, the part about let's stay hidden and not attract a bunch of attention and have people knocking on our door. Kind of important. Oh, please don't take this overboard. We need to be professional. Look, dude, look. Okay. When we get down to the ground, I'm gonna transform back from our human form. All right, your normal form. And we're gonna try to talk down the burglar. Okay? Okay. Good. Glad discussion. Let's go down then. What are you doing? Stop agitating the situation. No. We are not taking bullets if we don't have to. Would you just screw it? Okay. Sorry, Mr. Burglar. Yes, I do have you wrapped around in our tendrils. Yeah, you see, taking old lady's purse, not the nicest thing in the world. Apologies, you're about to lose your head. It was nice for you living, I guess. Bye. I can't believe we just ate him. I don't know why you wanted to do that. Look at the old lady. She's terrified. And she's gone. You see, you just scared the bejesus out of her, and she still didn't get her purse. Just leave it on the ground. Look, we need to be more subtle with our approach. This is barbaric. Look at us. We're a giant hulking mess. We are not like Venom. Do I have a problem against Venom? Of course I do. Look how much damage he causes every time he does something. Look, okay, take a look. Cathedral, for instance. The whole place is destroyed. Oh, don't even get me started on the hot dog stands. Or the Cheesecake Factory. Oh, that's like my favorite place. Yes, I'm mad at him over a cheesecake. Don't get mad at me. That, and I'm not really a fan of eating people versus him, you know? I mean, I get it, we have to, but, we can handle that with chocolate. We don't need to eat brains. As long as we have a nice, delicate piece of chocolate, we're happy. Well, I mean, we obviously want other things like, potatoes and pizza and, that really, 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 really delicious cheesecake, but it doesn't mean we have to go around killing everyone. No. We're not Cletus Cassidy, okay? We're not Carnage. We're not some great villain that needs to be defeated. Me and you, we have one goal: survival. We want to live. We want to survive. We want to live happy, right? The best way to do that is to try to draw not a lot of attention. I give you the gift of incredible strength, speed, and you can stab people with tendrils. Congratulations. Also, you can grab Pop-Tarts without having to use your hands. So, that's pretty awesome. But there's a cost to that power. Heavy metabolism, and you have me. You're always making all these choices, but I'm here too. You need to let me make some decisions. I know I told you I wouldn't take over, but you gotta let me make some decisions. This isn't just your body anymore. It's our body. And we need to be a team. I get it, you want to save the city, but a city doesn't need to be saved. There's no crazy villains running around, or there's nothing bad happening. Sure, there's a burglar or a thief or a rioter, but that's normal. And the police can take care of that. They don't need us for that. We don't need to be a lethal protector. We can just be us, you know? Toxin. Together. We don't need to be separated like this. Okay? So please believe me when I say that you're perfect the way you are. You don't need to make all these changes or be someone else just because you got a symbiote. You don't have responsibility. All right? Come on, let's go home. Your pancreas is starting to look kind of delicious, so let's get some chocolate in us. Oh my lord, is that caramel? I've never tried it, but the commercials always make it look so good. Can you please buy at least one of those? What do you mean we're low on money? I didn't spend all of it. I just have a select taste for chocolate. No caramel? Aw, come on. We gotta have some. At least one. One little bitty piece. Please? Yes. Oh, that's heaven. Actually, speaking of candy, are we gonna go trick-or-treating? No. Why not? We're too old for it. Oh, come on. You literally have the perfect costume. What am I referring to? Me. You can wear me. We end up walking around the bulky state. Or we can be that thing. It's not my fault. Actually, it is my fault. I hate it. I don't want to be like Dad. With all the tendrils and the oozingness, I much prefer the bulky state. At least that way we're more together. You know what I mean? I'm protecting you. It makes us feel secure. That form is a lot less secure. Then it rips your body apart. I mean, technically you don't feel it because I'm pumping your body full of numb, but having your chest ripped open is not a fun experience. Plus, it gives me major heartburn. Well, yeah. Are you really sure that form? I mean, I don't even use my regular form very often because it scares people. You know, mostly I just give you claws or let your main body do the work. That form is really taxing for both of us. That we eat a lot after we do it. The bulky form is a lot easier to maintain, and we don't have to eat obsessively. So it works better. You need my assistance with something? What's that? Huh? You want to go to a concert? I really think that's a bad idea. I'm sensitive to sound. Leave me at home? Absolutely not. I'll die before you come home. Did you forget what I am? I am a symbiote. I need to feed. And while I don't eat you, I do live off your chemicals. If I'm not attached to you, I will die. Just leave me with chocolate. That doesn't help. Like how you need, you know, vitamin C and vitamin D and to go out in the sun. I need those chemicals too. Okay? And I can't just bond to everyone, and I'm currently bonded to you. If I leave you, it will kill you. Okay? So, I'm sorry. I just have to take some charge here. I think that's an awful idea. Plus, what if Carnage or Venom comes for us? Right now, we're sticking our head low, but you've just exposed us multiple times. If they find us, if they find you, they will kill you. Without a second's hesitation. Why am I so sure about that? I suppose I should tell you why. Well, my grandpa, Venom, he was investigating a serial killer called Cletus Cassidy. And they got bit by Cletus Cassidy. Cletus Cassidy was then infected with carnage. How that works is it went into his blood. And then Cletus became Carnage. And now Carnage is nigh unstoppable. I am a product of Carnage. I'm his child. My intention of me being born was to infect someone and turn them into my slave. That was the purpose. But this officer I met, he showed me right from wrong. And with the law and what he taught me, I became better, but he had a family. So he had to make a tough choice so that his baby wouldn't be in danger. He sold me away, and I was driven off. It hurt. I was ripped from his body. He nearly died. Luckily, he was in a hospital, so he was rushed right into a bed. But I was the less fortunate one. When I was ripped from his body, it changed me. Changed my very nature being inside of him. I went from a murderous, evil, horrible being. What you see now. When symbiotes bond with someone, they inherit their quirks, their personalities. So I stole his personality. He's nothing but a drone now, unfeeling. But I took it with me, and I can't give it back. And now I'm with you, and I've absorbed many of your qualities, including the heroic bit, hence why I'm no longer fighting you as much on it. I want to be a hero with you, I do, but it's dangerous, and it puts both of us at risk. I can help you with your job, I can make your life better, I can speed up your metabolism, I can give you abs and muscles and all of that, but I can't fix what I am at the heart of it. I may be a symbiote, but I am a parasite. I'm a failure, and I know it. You don't have to say it. They're thinking it. You're tired of me. And you're hurting, too. You lost the ability to enjoy several of the things you liked. And now, the one thing you want to go do, I'm stopping you from it. I get it. I really do. And if you want to separate, I won't stop you, but you should know the risks. And you should know what happens if you separate from a symbiote. It'll probably kill you, and if not, you won't be the same person as before. You'll be changed. I'll either take a personality quirk, I'll take your hearing, your sight, your smell, and I wish I wouldn't. I don't want to take it. But I'm attached to you. I took away all your senses and integrated myself into you, like a parasite. Look, I can't fix this. It's already done. But I'm sorry. I wish I had better things to say. Do you forgive me? And you don't think I'm a monster? That's polite, but have you seen my teeth? Oh, they definitely could use a good brushing. Granted, we're definitely gonna have to do that after all the blood that's on them. Cheesecake Factory? Yeah, let's go. I'm hankering for a Reese's Cheesecake. Have you tried them? They're so good.